In this video, I'm going to give you an overview of the Teams application, as well as looking at the settings. This video forms part of a playlist where we dive into the main tabs of Teams, including Activity, Chat, Teams, Calendar, Calls, and Files. So here we've opened up into the Activity feed. Now, when you're in Teams, the first six options, so Activity through to Files, are all standard. But below this, you have three options which you can customize yourself. So here I'm using custom breakwater apps. If you use the more options below these, you can find a range of different apps. If, for example, I wanted OneNote to be one of my quick access tabs on the left, I could right click and press pin. Now, when you do this, it will automatically pin up here in your more options, but you can simply drag this and place it above the other apps. Now, when you click out of more options, OneNote is readily available there. Now, when you go into more options, it will show you the recent apps that you've accessed, but you can also use the search bar to find a specific app, or you can go to more apps. This will then open up the App Store for Teams, and you'll be able to see a range of different apps. So you have ones built for your organization. So this might be power apps that you specifically had built or built yourself. You can see ones that are also popular across Teams right now, like Communities, which is Yammer. Down the side here, you also have top picks, you have what's new, so you can see the recent apps added, and there are also categories, so ones for specific tasks such as project management or productivity, and you also have industry specific apps too. Above your left toolbar, you have this little back and forth arrow selection. So this essentially sends you back to the last place you were on Teams, so it's kind of handy if you want to flick back between where you were. Next to this along the top, you have your search bar. So this will search everything. It will look for messages, files. You can even type in certain commands into here as well. Along from this, we have more options. So this is where you would access your settings. Before we get into settings, I'm just going to cover these options here. So Zoom allows you to make your team slightly bigger or slightly smaller, depending on how you prefer to view it. It also allows you to bring up keyboard shortcuts. So there are a range of really helpful shortcuts here. Particularly these navigation shortcuts, which are Control 1 all the way through to 9, which correlate to the apps on the left-hand side. Next you have About. So this is where you can check your version history, so to make sure you're up to date. There's also things like legal, privacy and cookie notices and things like that in there. There is also this handy check for updates button. Hopefully yours should be kept up to date, but just in case you can check that here. And there's also the option to download the mobile app. So I'll head into settings next. So it will open up on your general settings first. Now at the very top, you have your theme. Now some people do prefer to use things like dark mode. And there is also a high contrast mode as well, which some people may prefer. But for the purpose of this video, I am going to stick with the default light mode though. Below this, you have your application settings. So auto start means that every time you switch on the computer, it will automatically open Teams for you. It's very handy if you use Teams every day to keep this on, as it means you don't have to worry about opening the application all the time. There's an option here, which is quite useful, which is open new chat in. So when you open a new chat with someone, you can have the option to either keep it within the Teams window or open it in a separate window altogether. There are also language options. So your app language can be changed as well as your keyboard language. And you can enable and disable spell check too. You can also set an out of office from Teams. This will sync with your Outlook though, so you don't have to worry about setting an out of office on both Teams and Outlook. Below General, you have an account section. So this just allows you to manage your account and sign in and out of your account, and it will show you which account you are currently logged in for. You can also add a profile picture here if you want to, and you can add a personal account. At the time of recording this video, you can't add a secondary work account, but it is something that is in the pipeline at the moment. Below accounts, you have privacy settings. So the first one here is Do Not Disturb. Now you can set a status which allows you to put yourself on Do Not Disturb, and I'll go through statuses later on. But here you can manage priority access. So that means that when you're on Do Not Disturb, certain people can be given access to send notifications still. So if, for example, you put yourself on Do Not Disturb, but you want messages to come through from your manager, then you can allow that to happen. Below this you have a blocked contact section, so you can block all calls with no caller ID if you want to, and you can also add and remove people from a blocked caller list. Below this you have keyboard shortcut unmute. So this is quite a handy one. You probably hear the saying all the time when you're on a video call that someone will be on mute. So here you can enable a shortcut which allows you to use control and the space bar to temporarily unmute yourself during a meeting. Read receipts let people know that you have seen their messages. If you prefer not to have that pressure of reading a message and then replying instantly because someone knows you read it, you can just switch them off here. Surveys, so occasionally Microsoft will send you surveys about Microsoft Teams. You can switch them off if you don't want to receive them. And then down the bottom here, you have optional connected experiences. So Teams does have some cloud-backed services, including Giphy, which is where you can access GIFs and URL previews. We'd recommend keeping them on as it just enhances the app altogether. Below privacy, we have notifications. So this is where you can tweak the notifications you receive for any chat messages or calls or any activity that you might have missed. So email refers to an actual email that you'll receive in your Outlook. So if, for example, you're not on Teams and there's a bunch of activity, you get a load of messages and things that have happened while you're not on there, you can schedule emails to be sent to your Outlook to tell you what is happening. You can change the frequency of them, so you can have them as soon as the activity happens, you can have them once every 10 minutes, hour, 8 hours, daily, and you can switch them off altogether. You can also change the appearance and sound of how you receive notifications. So you can change the style, so it can be a Windows notification or just within Teams itself. You can show message previews and you can stop it from playing sounds for incoming calls and notifications if you want to. You can also customize what kind of activity notifications you'll get. So you can receive all activities, you can only receive mentions and replies, or you can completely customize it yourself. This can be done below. So you have chat, meetings and calls, people and other. So if you were to edit your chat notifications, then you can change how you receive them. So if you're mentioned, do you want a banner to pop up and for it to go in your feed or only in your feed? The choices are all there and they're all customizable through all these notifications. Below notifications is devices. The speaker settings here is how you hear audio. So if you have headphones plugged in and you have speakers set up, do you want to go through a laptop? Do you want to go through the speakers? Do you want it to go through the headphones? You also have the same for your microphone. So if you have a specific microphone plugged in, you can change for the sound to come through that as opposed to your laptop device. And below this, you have make a test call. And what that will essentially do is open up a video call with yourself. It will check your connection, it will check your audio, it will check your camera, and it will basically score it. Noise suppression allows you to suppress the noise around you, so you can either have it high, low, off, or on auto. You can also set secondary ringers. So if you want to ring both through your speakers and through your headset, then you can do that. And you can also select different camera options. So if you want to use a camera on your laptop, or perhaps you have a specific camera plugged in, you can switch between those there. After devices, we have app permissions. So this is basically your permissions for like your camera, to track your location, notifications, and it allows you to set your permissions for external apps that are in Teams too. So for example, do you want OneNote to access your camera, microphone, and speakers? Captions and transcripts. So when you're in a meeting, if you are identified in the meeting, you can automatically set captions and transcripts for that meeting. Files, so you can have a preference on where you want files to open from Teams. So you have three options. So if you open files in Teams, that means they will just pop up in the Teams application. If you choose the desktop application, that means it'll open in a separate application. So that means Word will pop open as a separate application. Or you have browser, which will take you to the web version of Office. And lastly, in the settings, you have calls. So this is for your Teams call section. So you can put your calls on forward, you can configure your voicemail and change your ringtones in here. So now we've been through settings, we're just going to look at our profile icon here. And this is where you can set your status. So at the moment you can see I've got a green tick and that means that I am available. But there is a range of different options. So if you're busy, you can set it to busy. If you go on Do Not Disturb, as I mentioned earlier, this will stop your team's notifications, with the exception of the people you excluded on your list in your settings. You can also put Be Right Back, or Appear Away, or Appear Offline. You can also set durations for these, so if you want to appear busy for today, for 2 hours, for the whole week, you can do that here. It is also worth noting that these do connect to Outlook and to your team's meetings. So if you have an appointment in your calendar, it will set your status to busy. If you're in a Teams meeting and you are screen sharing, it will set you to Do Not Disturb, so it stops those notifications from appearing when you are sharing your screen. You can also set a status message. You can type the message in here, and you can tick the option to show when people message you. So if someone tries to start a chat conversation with you, that message will pop up so they're aware of what's going on. You can also set a timestamp on this message too. And then below that, it also does give you the handy option to just schedule an out of office. As I said, this does sync with your Outlook, so if you set an out of office in here, it will also set one on Outlook for you. And then also just up here, it's handy to note that once again, you can change your profile icon by clicking on it here. Now below this section, you have saved. So when you're in a chat with someone, you can actually save a message and then you can come back to it in here. So as you can see, I've got this chat message saved here and I can just quickly access it. If we go back into our icon, we then have manage account. So if you open that up, that will take you to your settings and into your accounts section there. Back up here, you again have the option to add a personal account, and as I said, hopefully there will be the option to add multiple work accounts as well. And you have the option to sign out too. So that is an overview of the Teams interface. If you continue watching this playlist, you will see our deep dive into Activity, Chat, Teams, Calendar, Calls, and Files too.